If you're ready, let me hear it. How about like level 10, I'm ready right now. I want to learn something today. That's, if you're like level 10 ready to learn something, can we hear that right now? All right, there we go. That's better. I love it. You guys are great. So here's the deal. Today, we're going to dive in. We're going to get deep. We're going to go tactical. There's a lot of information. We're going to talk some sales stuff this morning. We've got two great DVMs in the house that are going to share with us their perspective on building an epic and super successful events program. Amy and I are going to be diving into marketing and giving you strategy on that. We're going to do breakouts that have sales training, live role plays. We've got coordinator breakouts. We're going to get into like how to run a $1 million program plus. So a lot of great stuff to cover. Here's what we need from you guys today. I know some of you are new. This is your first net event. You're just getting started to work. Like you're just getting started on an events team. Some of you have been around for a couple years and you're having some success and you know you're getting some traction and you're building your customer base and you're selling a lot and you know you're breaking through. You were here maybe last year at last year's net meeting and you're back this year to take it to the next level. Some of you are seasoned veterans. You've been around for years. This is not your first rodeo. This is not your first home and garden show training. This is not your first state fair training. Right? You've been doing this for years and you know what you're doing and you're at the high level and you're here to get those tweaks, those fine-tuning. You're here to fine-tune your approaches, to fine-tune, you know, your business, to fine-tune your marketing strategy. You're here to connect with people, build relationships and stuff like that. And so I'm excited to share with you guys today a couple really great things just to kick off the morning when it comes to packages and upserves. So thank you for having me. I think about like where I came from in this business. It's funny. I was talking with Rob Robinchek last night, who's one of my original mentors in the business. Is Rob in the room right now? Where's Rob at? There he is. Rob, please stand up. Just so you guys know, Rob Robinchek is actually one of the very first people to ever set up a booth and sell Cutco at an event. Literally like 15, 16, 17 years ago before there ever even was an event program and event booking department before there ever were. This was back when like we had to front the money for shows, and he was paying $3,000 for home and garden shows back then out of his own pocket. So he's one of the godfathers of the events program. If we could just give him a quick round of applause, that's awesome. You know, when I trained in the events program, I was trained don't sell at the booth, just sign up leads, go do demos for people. That worked really great for a very short period of time. It actually didn't work great at all, so that's why we changed it. And Rob was one of the pioneers in how to sell at the booth. You know, I remember when the first like national training program came out. It was all about how to sell cheese knives and upsell from there. You know, hey, when you see Cutco owners, get them sold on a cheese knife. You know, when you talk to brand new customers, buy two get one free specials, stuff like that. And it's interesting to see how things have changed over the years. Right? Nowadays, the last couple years, we've got people like Jason Jeffrey, who pioneers the ultimate upgrade approach. We've got people like Curtis Jacques, who's like, hey, we can sell sets at the booth in a matter of minutes. It doesn't take a full 45-minute in-home demo to get people to spend $3,000 or $4,000 or $5,000 on Cutco. You know, we've got other people who are breaking through and, you know, selling Cutco kitchens at the booth. You know, Kelly Martins did one last year at State Fair of Texas. We've seen it happen multiple times. We have brand new people on the Texoma Fair team or the Texoma events team, you know, because of the leadership of Brian Carter. We've got three brand new people. Their first one, two, or three shows sold their first Cutco kitchens of their entire careers. Some of these guys are at $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 in sales. It's really amazing to see the evolution of our training and the mindset, the thinking that everybody has. How many of you see like posts on Facebook or you listen to audios and you're like, holy crap, I would love to sell a Cutco kitchen at the booth. Holy crap, I would love to sell a three-piece or five-piece special and then upsell a flatware chest on top of that. If that would be cool for you, raise your hand. Yeah, exactly. You should. By the way, that was a trick question. You all should be raising your hands, even if you've done it before, right? So I'm excited because I've seen this stuff work in my business, learning from people from all over the country, watching other people work, applying this stuff into my business. And I went from being a guy who really struggled at selling and having to, you know, I actually was so bad at selling at the booth, so bad, that I actually called Rob one day and was like, hey, Rob, this is years ago, Tulsa State Fair. The first year we did the Tulsa State Fair, we worked 11 days, we sold $3,000. Yeah, 11 days, $3,000. That fair now does $120,000 in 11 days. So, and we're positioned to do more and more and grow year after year after year. So, but the reason that we made that shift at that fair was because I called Rob one day and was like, dude, listen, I suck at selling at the booth. Can I pay to bring you to Tulsa to work this event with me for 3 days and just watch you sell? Because I need to learn how to sell in the booth. And he did that. You know, he sacrificed his own time. You know, he came down, he worked the event and sold like, I don't know, $4,000 or $5,000 in a weekend. And I was like, holy crap, like blew my mind. Right? And I remember him telling me, hey, that girl next door that's interested in Cutco, she keeps asking you questions. Like, get that deal closed. And I sold her a homemaker builder. Like, the day after he left, I just went in for it. I sold her a homemaker builder. It was the first set I ever sold at the booth. And I was like, oh, my God, people actually do spend hundreds of dollars on knives at a show like this. It's amazing, right? It just changed my mind. That woman, Carrie Flood, she's one of my best customers now. She's bought over $10,000 worth of Cutco from me. She has a Cutco kitchen now. She has bought engraved gifts for her family and her friends. She has, you know, given out pocket knives to her husband's a trucker, so they give out pocket knives to like all their trucker friends and stuff like that. And it's just amazing to think about how things have changed. And so I know what it's like to start off small and grow and get better and better and better over the years. And so what I want to share with you today is just what I've found, just a couple concepts. I want to share with you today what I call my scaling offer formula. I want to help you guys understand how to think about the products, the packages, and the programs that we sell. I want to walk you through the handout, which I'm going to ask you to stay with me in the handout as we go through it, but walk you through kind of the concept of how to think about the three different ways that you can offer products to your customers, because there's really, what I've found, three different types of customers that we end up working with. People are interested in products, people are interested in packages, and people are interested in programs. Maybe they're not interested, maybe they don't know that they're interested, but they're qualified, they're prospects for one of these three different areas. I mean, if you're working with a qualified customer, they're going to buy one of these three different things. And so I want to share with you the concept of that and how it works and how to think about it and how to really look at it in the booth. And then I'm going to share, you know, just the different packages and programs to consider. We're going to go through also a list of quality engaging questions. A lot of people ask, you know, last night even there was the question like, hey, so how do I actually introduce the bigger packages to people? What's the question that seeds that and that conversation with that customer? We're going to talk about that today. So the goal is that by the end of my message, you guys have some tactical stuff that you can use and start implementing. Some key golden lines that open the door for you to show different packages, different programs to your customers. If you guys are interested in that, if you're excited about that, can I hear you go, oh yeah?
Oh yeah.
All right, cool. So let's get to work. By the way, I'm not going to spend a lot of time telling stories. I'm just going to spend a lot of time getting deep with you guys and going tactical. Here's what to do. Here's what to say. Here's how it works, right? Here's why this stuff makes sense. So the goal of the message today is to help you think bigger. No matter who you are, think bigger and increase the arsenal of things that you can sell to your customers. See, what's cool is that our product line is limited. It is what it is. But the way that we present and introduce the product line to our customers, there's a lot of different ways that we can play around with it. And that's what's exciting, is that you can take all the different things that we sell and present them in different ways depending on who you're with, depending on what type of prospect you're talking to. And so, three things to sell. Three ways to really think about this. We've got three things we sell, guys. We sell individual products. And then we sell packages. And then we sell programs. And so a lot of people, I find, when they come cross-training or when we're coaching in our conversations, are focused in the product world. You know, a big question that I always get is, hey, man, my demos take a really long time. My service calls take a really long time. How many of you have ever done like the 2.5-3 hour service call where you showed every single product to that customer and built the big wish list, and it was just individual products? And by the end, they were like, oh, my God, my brain hurts. Anybody ever had that happen, right? Like, how many of you are demonstrating products at the booth and you notice that sometimes customers just kind of lose interest or they disconnect, right? Well, sometimes what happens is we get so caught up showing individual items, which is not a bad thing, right? But if we're showing individual items to the wrong people, they get bored, they disconnect. And if you're really trying to master your sales process, you want to maintain, you want to not just establish a connection with the customer, you want to maintain that connection all the way throughout your whole sales experience. Right? And for some people, they think bigger. They are interested in bigger stuff. And so when I made the transition from showing just 150 different products, I was able to extremely shorten my learning curve when I started saying, you know what, there's got to be a more effective, more efficient way to actually present our product line to our customers. And that's where I said, you know, I want to start like packaging things up. And I started learning from Curtis and Jason and multiple other people in this room. And what I noticed is that they were focusing on packages more. You know, they were focusing on knife sets, flatware chests, cookware sets, gadget sets. Dante Reynolds, are you in the room right now? Where you at? All right, cool. Dante, stand up really quick. Where you at? There he is, front row. So Dante, just so you know, is going to be one of our next, how many of you listen to my interview in audios? How many of you don't even know what I'm talking about when I say that? Raise your hand if you're not getting the interview audios. So some of you are getting the interview audios, but you're not listening to them. So I'm going to challenge and encourage you guys to listen to the interview audios, because I'm getting on the phone with people who are top in the business and asking them, hey, what are you doing to be successful? And one of the next interviews that we're going to do is going to be with Dante, because he's got this Hunter's package that he's selling, where how many of you have had that person that walks up that's like, you know, it's the guy, you can tell he's kind of interested, or like he goes straight to the hunting knives, you know, and he's like, you know, he kind of moseys on up to the booth. He's like, oh, what's up, you know, hunting knives? Yeah. These sharp, right? And most of us, how many of you in the room are guilty for being like, dude, get out of here? Like, raise your hand if you've ever done that. Or you're like, oh man, this guy, right? How many of you just, no matter what, you're not going to raise your hand? Right, exactly. So Dante's found a way to actually close these guys, to get them interested and close them and actually take them, like with his hunter's package. And it's a really cool package. It's really good. But he's basically taken a bunch of hunting knives and packaged them up into a bigger deal and then is showing that to his customers. And what's cool about it is because he's showing it as a package, he's showing a bigger ticket item in the same amount of time as it takes to show an individual product. So you'll want to look for that audio if you want to know how to sell hunter's packages. So, but the idea here is really, think about it like this. You want to know your stuff so good. Like, you want to know how to present all of the products inside and out, every individual product. You want to know what is the challenge that people experience with it. What is the thing that people, you know, what is the challenge that they experience? How do we solve that challenge? And you want to know how to help them visualize what that product can do for them long term. And when you get to know that on every individual product, well, then what you want to do is you want to start to think to yourself, how do we package these products up into bigger packages? I like to look at it from $1,000 packages. So when I first started to make the transition, I was like, okay, I want to have, instead of 100 different $50 to $200 items that I'm showing, I want to have like 10 $1,000 packages that I'm showing to my customers. And then, you know, figure out, like, what is the challenge that people have with this package in their home or in their hunting experience or in their outdoor experience and stuff like that. And then how do we solve that challenge with this package? And then how do we get them to really imagine the benefit that they can have by having this package in their home or in their truck or, you know, wherever, depending on what they're buying. And then what's really cool is that when you've got a bunch of packages and you get really good at selling the different packages that we sell, you know, the upgrades, the knife sets, the flatware chests, the cookware, the outdoor packages, the hunting packages, the accessory packages, all of that stuff, when you get good at selling the packages, well, then you can bundle those things up and present them as programs to our customers. You know, multiple knife sets, multiple knife sets as gifts. Multiple gift packages, you know, you can start to present it as a business gift program, as a family program, you take multiple packages and put them together and make it the Cutco Kitchen program. And then what's great is that when you're working with customers, you get to a point where when you can tell you're with a really qualified prospect, like what Matt was talking about last night, they pay for an ultimate in full. It's just kind of like, well, if you're able to drop $3,000 now in full, I should probably tell you about our program that we have called our Cutco Kitchen program, right? And now, if you learn how to do this stuff where you're not just, you don't just know what the challenge and the solution and what life is like with the packages and the products, but you also can do that with the programs, that's where you can then really connect with people. And when you find out you're with a qualified prospect, you can go to the programs. Or when you find out that you're with somebody who they just need one specific thing, you can go to a package. Or when you find out that you're with that person who, you know, you can tell they're just a pieces customer. How many of you have ever met the pieces customer at the booth where you want to show them a knife set, but they're just like, can I just buy a paring knife? Can I just buy pieces? How many of you know what I'm talking about? Like, yeah, these people? Yeah, right? Well, those are the people that you show products to. Does that make sense? So you go individual products with people who are interested in individual items, you meet them where they're at. You know, you help them feel understood, like Jason likes to talk about, help people really feel understood. Hey, you know what? It seems like you're really just interested in some individual items here. Let me go ahead and show you our individual products that we have for you. But for people who you can tell they're better quality, they're better qualified, they're more interested in what you have to show them than what they think they need, well, those are the people you show show packages to. So here's the idea. When you bundle things together, that's where the deals can get really fun, right? That's one of the lines you guys learned yesterday. It's a line that's changed for me. Like, when it comes to upserving, it's like, hey, Mrs. Jones, just so you know, the more you get, the more you save. And what's great is when you bundle things together, that's where the deals get really cool. Like, there's somebody in our division that says, you know, when you bundle things together, that's where things get really sexy, right? And you don't have to say that if you don't want to. It's just, you know, you could. So, three things to sell: products, packages, and programs. So, here's how you get it, right? You can show, you can get anything sold when you know how to connect with people's challenges. What is it that your customers are really challenged with? What is the struggle? What is the challenge? When you connect with that, it creates understanding. When you talk about that with your clients, hey, do you ever have this experience at home? Have you ever felt this way? You know, my Cutco kitchen line, for example, is, hey, you know, do you guys, have you ever had that experience where you have that block full of like random mix-match knives, or the drawer full of mix-match knives, the hodgepodge of cookware in the drawer or in the cupboards, and the mix-match silverware? And customers are always like, oh, yeah, that's exactly what I have at home. I'm like, yeah. It kind of sucks, doesn't it? Like, you have to buy this stuff over and over and over again. It's like every single time that you buy it, you're hoping that this is the last can opener you're ever going to have to buy. And you're just praying that this is it. This is the one, right? This is the Neo of can openers. And then you get it home, and 2 months later, you're like, man, I got screwed again. And customers are like, yeah, I know what you're talking about, right? Oh, man, let me tell you about why the Cutco Kitchen program is something that really solves all those problems for you, right? Now what you do is you present the solution. You connect with the challenge and the struggle that the customer's having at home, and then they feel understood, they feel related to, like, you get them. You're the professional. You know most people have this experience, and then here's the solution. So, cool, let me tell you real quick about our Cutco Kitchen program and why it's actually our best deal and how we help people solve that problem for the rest of their lives. We help you get best-in-class, American-made stuff. It's guaranteed forever. You get your full knife set, your full cookware set, your full flour set, all your gadgets, serving pieces, and accessories. Some people buy it all at once. Some people build it out over time. Our goal is to help figure out what you need most and find the best solution for you. And customers are like, oh, cool. When you provide a really good solution that shows them how they can actually solve all those challenges that you just brought up and had, you know, that you talked to them about, well, now they feel the need for it. Now they're like, oh, man, I really need this, because you're connecting with their emotions through talking about their challenges, and then you're giving them a logical approach, a logical solution that helps them solve all those problems. So they naturally go, well, that's something I want. Now, whether or not they can get it is another story. That's what closing is for. But ultimately, they feel the need for it. I have a lot of clients that are like, wow, that's what I really want. I definitely want to get there, but I definitely can't spend $7,000 today. And I'm like, that's okay. My goal is just to figure out what you are comfortable getting and help you get that. Something you know you're going to use, something you are comfortable getting started with, something that does fit your budget. Let's figure that out. Now it's all about serving the client. It's all about helping the client. They know that I'm there for their best interests, right? And so, you know, now they feel that need, and then all we have to do after that is just get them to visualize what it's like. Now, I learned this from Seth, actually, in one of our coaching calls. It's funny how Seth paid me to coach him, and then I learned this from him during our coaching sessions, where I was like, dude, what is one of the best things that you do with your clients? Just helping him discover for himself the things that he really could lean into to make work at a higher level. And he was like, well, one of the things I do is I always ask my customers, I always say, you know, like, so imagine if you never had to buy knives again, cookware again, flatware again. Now, he gave me the imagine if statement. You know, imagine if this was the last ice cream scoop you ever had to buy. Imagine if every time you cut into your ice cream, it just cut right through it nice and easy and gave you the perfect scoop. You throw it in the bowl, put it in the dishwasher. It's gonna be fine after you take it out of the dishwasher. And it's going to be the last ice cream scoop you ever have to buy for the rest of your life. Mrs. Jones, what would that be like? And they go, oh, man, that would be awesome. It's like, I know, right? High five. This is the scoop that will help you feel that way, right? So thank you to Seth for giving me the imagine if stuff. And here's what I've learned, right? You can do an imagine if, you can do a visualization conversation like Brandon talked about with every single product that we sell. You just have to do the work to figure that stuff out. Go cross-train with other people. Study the scripts. You know, learn from your mentors. Or write it all out yourself and ask yourself, like, what is the challenge with every product that most people experience? What is the solution that we provide with our product line? And if people did solve this challenge, what would life be like for them if they didn't have to worry about that challenge anymore? And what's great is you can do that with every product, you can do it with every package, and you can do it with every program, right? So Mrs. Jones, imagine if your kitchen was stocked for the rest of your life. You knew that for the rest of your life, you never had to buy cookware, flatware, or knives again, forever. Imagine if you were able to use high-quality American-made stuff. Imagine if every single time that you picked up your knives, your cookware, or your flatware, you went to use that, you thought to yourself, this is awesome. I've got best in class. And you just knew it was going to work. You just knew that you never had to replace it, because if it ever did need sharpening, if anything ever did get damaged, if anything ever did get worn out, it was going to be taken care of for you for free forever. And you could pass that on to the next generation. What would that be like? And I love that question. What would that be like, Mrs. Jones? And they always go, it'd be pretty awesome. I'm like, I know, right? I know. That's where you can get enthusiastic, high-five your customers, and they start to now want the stuff that you're showing. It becomes their idea. They start to ask those buying questions like, well, how much is this stuff? Or how do I get some? Or can I buy just a knife set if I want to start there? Can I buy just individual pieces? They start to ask those questions. And so now it's not like you're pitching and pushing sales on your customers anymore. Instead, you're making a very personal approach, and it starts to become their idea. So let's talk about the packages. Right? You got to know your stuff. You got to know your stuff. So here's some packages to consider, right? So let's go through the handout here really quick. So here's the packages to consider, right? Packages, knife sets, upgrades, flatware, cookware, gifts. Those are the most basic ones. Here's a few extras if you want to write them down on your handout, right? Oh, look at this. So my PowerPoint's out of order. That's my bad. Boom. All right. Knife sets, upgrades, flatware, cookware, gifts. Right? Here's another one. Accessory items. All the gadgets, the bacon serve set. The kitchen tools set. I call it like my accessories and serving pieces package. Right? We've got this package that's got all the accessories and all your serving items. Kitchen tools, bacon serve set. Gadgets. Add it up. It's about $800. $800 package, just like that. Another one, the outdoor package. Garden tools. Barbecue set. A collection of hunting, fishing, and pocket knives. All the outdoor stuff. Right? It's a $1,000 to $2,000 package, depending on how you put it together. What do you get excited about selling? Like, what are you most excited about? How can you package those products up and turn them into a $1,000 package? For me, it's like 10 gift sets. Any 10 gift set combo or 5 gift set combo is a $1,000 to $2,000 package. And you just ask, like, hey, have you ever considered giving the gift to Cutco before? Oh, cool. Do you have, you know, 5 or 10 people on your gift list that are really hard to buy for every year? Oh, you do? Okay, cool. I'm going to show you one of our packages that we have for our clients here where you can actually get all your gift shopping taken care of in a matter of minutes, once a year. Never have to worry about doing it again. You guys see that, right? So how many packages can you put together? You can come up with your own. You know, you could do steak knife packages, table knife packages. You do a collection of different things, however you want to do it. Some programs to consider are the Cutco Kitchen Program, the Family Program, and the Business Gift Program. These are like our three staple programs. If you want to sell things that are multiple thousands of dollars, This is what you want to show. And here's the cool thing. You can cover, like the idea is you meet the customer where they're at, right? Sell them a knife set if that's what they're there for. But then when you do your upserving, you talk about the other stuff. You talk about the other packages. You talk about our programs. And you just ask them leading questions or use interest phrasing and leading questions to see which things you should show them. And I gave you a list of different questions that you can ask to open the door for these, to lead into the packages, to lead into the programs. And here's what happens, right? When you're upserving, you can go from a garlic press to a flatware chest. I mean, sorry. I have an old story in my brain where it's like customer came up, sold them a garlic press. They're like, I don't need anything else. And all I did was I went through, and we don't have a garlic press anymore, just so you know. So, but it was like garlic press. Some of you are like, garlic press? And what's that? So, many of you in the room sold garlic presses for a long time. But what I would do is I just went through all the packages. I'm like, hey, just so you know, the more you get, the more you save. So do you ever this, or have you ever this, or have you ever that? And they're like, no, we're good. I think we're good. No, I'm not interested in that. I don't need that. And then I got to the flatware package, and they were like, oh, flatware? Tell us about that. And you dive in, and you sell the flatware, right? And it was just like a garlic press, which was like a $35 order at that time, went to a $1,300 order, just like that. Because all I did was went through the upserving strategy, right? The interest phrasing of upserving, asked some good leading questions around the different packages, and then as soon as I sold that flower chest, I showed them the family program. We talked about that, and we talked about the business gift program, and we talked about the Cutco Kitchen program. And worst case scenario, what happens is they don't show interest in anything, but you've planted a whole bunch of seeds for the future. And I have hundreds of customers who've come by the booths year after year after year and now have Cutco Kitchens as a result of having these conversations with them at the booth. Just making sure that I'm always talking about our packages, always talking about the different programs, and seeing if it's something that they're interested in doing now or if it's something that they're interested in doing in the future. Right? Getting it on their wish list, just like the panel talked about yesterday during the questions, right there at the end. Show them everything. Take the time to do that. And what's cool is that when you're showing in terms of packages and programs, it doesn't take as much time. You can do it in a matter of minutes because you're not trying to go through 150 products. Instead, you're going through a handful of packages. So let's talk about some engaging questions, right? So in the handout, here's the packages, right? Knife sets. Are you looking for a great set to help you get everything you need and be done buying knives? Can I take a quick minute to show you why the knife sets are the best value that we offer for you? You know, that's something when somebody's like, yeah, I might just be interested in some pieces, I'll just ask that question. You know, hey, our knife sets are our best values. Could I take a quick second to show you why they're our best value, or do you just want to look at pieces? Give them the option, but at least let them know that they're the best value. And because you're posing it in terms of the best value, sometimes people will be like, yeah, you can show me the sets, and many of those people will buy a set if you know your sets approach. Upgrades. Have you seen the preferred customer upgrade program that you're qualified for as a Cutco owner yet? That's not exactly how Curtis says it, but I heard Curtis say that for the first time. And it's just the whole idea of, like, because you're a Cutco owner, you're qualified for our special upgrade program. Have you seen that yet? It's an intriguing question that makes people go, no, I haven't seen it. Oh, cool. Can I take a quick second to show that to you? Can I take a quick minute to show you why this is our best value for Cutco owners? Flatware. Do you happen to have the mixed match or incomplete set of everyday flatware at home like most people? Now, here's what's cool. That question, what I love about that question is that you get one of two answers. One person goes, yeah, that's me. Now you know you've got a qualified flatware prospect. But then you get those other people who are like, oh, man, no. I got four sets of flatware. We just inherited my mom's flatware. I have my same flatware from 30 years ago. Oh, is it all complete? Yep, got every piece. I've kept track of it. I got tracking devices on each of my forks so they don't get lost. And then I got the gold-plated stuff that I never use. I got that silver set that grandma gave me that I never use either. We're good on flatware, buddy. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. Guess what? I'm not really going to try to show them flatware. Instead, I'm going to go to cookware. I'm going to go to a different package, right? Because if I try to force flatware on that person and tell them, like, hey, I know you got four complete sets that you're totally happy with and you're good on flatware, but you should check out our flatware, I'm not really in, like, serving them, right? I don't really have their best interest in mind. I'm not really listening to them. They don't really feel understood. And so we risk eroding trust at that moment. And that's not what you want to do with your customers, right? So what's great about these quality leading questions is that these quality leading questions, engaging questions, they immediately help you identify who to show stuff to and who not to show stuff to. Does that make sense? Cool. So gifts, cookware, they're on there. Programs, right? So I gave you the leading questions and then the transition questions. When you look through these questions, it's like the leading question and that piques their interest and helps you identify, is this somebody that I want to show this to or not? And then if it is somebody, then your transition question, which is like the permission question to actually show this to them. And here's the great thing. When they give you permission to show them something, guess what? Are they more or less interested in what you're showing them? They're more interested. Who feels like they're in control? They do. The customer does, right? But who's actually in control? You are. So what you're doing is you're using strategic quality questions to guide the conversation quickly exactly where you want it to go. And you're also using their answers to the questions to quickly identify where you should go deeper with a customer and where you should move on to the next thing instead. And that's why it makes it super fast, right? Super fast. People watch me when they come cross-train with me, which, by the way, our national cross-trainers, can you guys stand up really quick? Curtis, Jason, Alicia. I'm excited because I will tell you that in May at the CSP Summit, we will be announcing expansion of the National Cross-Training Program. So we're really excited about that. Dave Bush and I just had a meeting in Philadelphia last week where we talked about the National Cross-Training Program that will be expanding. We're hearing your feedback. And so we're excited that we're finally in a position where we can make that happen. But if you don't know, you can go train with Curtis for a day. You can go train with Jason for a day. You can come train with me for a day. You can go train with Alicia Andrew for a day. And the company will pay you $200 to help comp you for your travel expenses. And so we've done literally over the past 5-6 years since we implemented this program, hundreds and hundreds of cross trains. How many of you have ever been cross trained by one of the national cross trainers? Please stand up really quick. I just want to show you. There's a commonality that you're going to see. Those of you that are still sitting down, just look around the room. And here's the thing. Stay standing. Those of you that have been cross-training, stay standing. Here's the thing you're going to see. Every person in this room, what they have in common is that they're all top performers. And I'm not going to say that's because of cross-training only. What I will tell you is it has a lot to do with it. When you get to watch the masters work, it's like you get to see the scripts in motion. You get to hear the questions in motion. You get to actually ask questions immediately based on individual situations, and it changes everything. How many of you would go cross-training again because of how much you learned from cross-training? Raise your hand. Look at that, 100% batting average. If you've not been cross-training with one of the national cross-trainers, I'm going to encourage you to do that. For sure, you guys can grab a seat, thank you. So, and I don't say that just to promote myself or Curtis or Jason, or it's just a way to help you get things going at a faster, higher level, right? But here's the great thing. People come, they watch me cross-train, and everybody wants to see, like, how do you upserve, Josh? Because you do the upserving training. I know that's like one of my master skills, and I love upserving. And people are always like, oh, now I get it. Like, you just keep asking the questions, and you just keep showing things over. Like, you just keep showing different things until they tell you that they're done. And it's like, yes, absolutely. Just because they say no to flatware or they're not interested in cookware doesn't mean I don't show the next thing. Doesn't mean I don't show wellness mats. Doesn't mean I don't tell them about Utopian. Doesn't mean I don't talk about the family program. Doesn't mean that I don't try to show them everything else that we have, right? And if I find that they're not connecting with packages, then you just go to products instead. See if that works. Try individual products. If I find that they're not connecting with individual products, they're pointing and asking about bigger packages, then I go to packages. If I find that, they're not connecting with any of that stuff, then always show programs. Always talk about the Cutco Kitchen program. Always ask if they own a business or work for a business that gives gifts. Do you own a business? Do you happen to own a business or work for a company that gives gifts out to their employees, to their clients, to their referring partners? And always talk about the family program. Always, always, always. I tell every customer about the family program. Hey, how many kids do you have? 2? Great. How old are they? Oh, they're in elementary school? Awesome. I should tell you about our family program really quick. I do it. I have sold people multiple sets for their elementary school children. And I had the first time it ever happened, a lady told me, she said, I think I'm going to buy 3 of these sets. I'm like, but your kids are in elementary school. She's like, yeah, I know, but I get the catalog every year, and I notice that the only thing that changes on Cutco is the price just keeps going up. And I mean, the shelf life on this stuff is forever because you're guaranteed. So I figure if I buy them now, when they do get married in 20 years, hopefully 30, right? I'll have saved a whole bunch of money over all those years by not paying your price increase over and over and over again. And I'm like, can you say that again? It's like, I just took what she said and now I say it to every customer. That's how I sell the family program. I was like, I had this customer one time and here's what she did and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And I just tell them the whole thing and they're like, oh yeah, that makes sense. I'm like, so, is that something you'd be interested in considering talking about today? You'd be surprised how many people say yes. And sometimes they say no, but now the seed's planted. And 3, 4, 5 years down the road, who gets the phone call when somebody's getting married? You do. So here's the deal, guys. To wrap it up, take this handout. Memorize these questions. Start showing your products, not just as products, but also bundled up in packages and bundled up as programs. If you do that consistently over time, you'll be amazed how much more interest you get in business gifts, how much more interest you get in Cutco kitchens, how much more interest you get in flatware chests, cookware sets, gift sets, and stuff like that. And how much time you'll save because you'll become much more effective and much more efficient with your customers. So, good stuff, yes or yes?